Hi, in this video I will convert the VPL C24 with a brushless outrunner and I will test it against the VPL D12 I converted last week. I am so much into outrunner brushless conversion that next week I will also review an Axial SGX10 converted with an outrunner brushless motor. So we will see what you need for the conversion. Then we will have a step-by-step instruction how to mount it and a test run and finally the conclusions. Let's start it. So what you need for the conversion is brushless outrunner motor, shaft extension, then piece of aluminum and of course the brushless speed controller. Another option would have been to use this type of coupling which is for the propeller. This because the original motor shaft is very long, it is 60 mm. And now let's see a step-by-step instruction. Let's disassemble the plastic body and remove the transmission. Then you have to measure the transmission support in order to replicate it on a piece of aluminum. Those are the measurements. Then you bend it 90 degrees in order to be able to fit on the frame. Okay, fits perfectly. And now let's sign where to put all the holes. And now the holes for the shaft, the motor shaft. Here I suggest you to use a big drill like 10, 12. So also the shaft can fit into it, the transmission shaft. Okay, all perfect. Now you have to remove the screw which keep the shaft of the motor in place. You remove the G and you have to beat the shaft down in order to be halfway. So the shaft has to be out from on the two sides of the motor, like this. Then you tie again the nut which is blocking the shaft. And finally you make the one flat part of the shaft in order to have a better grip for the screw. Then you need to enlarge a little bit the transmission shaft hole because the original shaft is 3 mm while this motor has 3.17 mm. And then you just fix it with the screws and you are done. Now take a piece of 3 mm shaft and place it on the shaft adapter. Make a dent in order for the cardan to be able to grab the new axle and place everything back together. Now let's drill a hole on the rear body in order for the battery plug to pass on the battery compartment of the car. And then remove this little bump in order to stick with the biadesive tape the speed controller on this position. Connect the motor cables and put the chassis on the rear body. Then stick the receiver, I place it here on the rear of the servo block. Then connect the LED cable, put the body on the top, and you are done. I used a 2-cell 600 mAh battery. And now the test ride. So the car is very grippy, but it's not easy to drive because it's easy to flip. It has a lot of acceleration and maybe too much speed, but still you can run also at low speed, like in this moment, for instance. In the cement it has no cogging, but in the grass sometimes it has a hard time starting and it cogs a lot. And I don't know, I think it is worth it. Maybe it will not last too much because it is too fast, but it's for sure funny, and I'm happy that I modified it.